Michael Foss, now good evening. The program in the watch now. Udota. Udota now the heart of the matter. With the reach you from Independent Television, Edo State, Nigeria. Mm-hmm. And every Monday and every Friday like this, we always call you at this kind of time to discuss issues and get to do with Nigeria, Africa, and the whole world. And of course, Naimi Kos still this time. Today again, we don't come here, and my name is Naima Akololo. There were some people who say we want to discuss so many issues and get to do with our country. This time around, now the health, our health. Of course, you know, see coronavirus. Now, what we see, we know if we talk. Now, we don't see, yes, more, some churches on the open, so many things that happen. But we will come to the final solution to this issue now. So we don't deal with them. So now that let me come say, yes, make we discuss the way out of this thing. How can we get a homegrown solution to this issue of coronavirus? We don't feel your day like that, just wait for only the time when we say, oh, you will come tell us now maybe the solution. Because one discuss, say, some things, we really feel do them. Because God bless us with most of this. I deal with a consultant physician, yes, a consultant family medicine, rather, Dr. Liu Asibidi. Doctor, good evening, sir.
Thank you. Yes, thank you, too.
Doctor, not just only a doctor, is also a consultant. Make I add that name because you know, see, most of the time, all these programs see they read book when you don't call their name, when you get with it. So, I call him again a consultant family physician, Dr. Liu Asibidi. All right, I deal with Sir Tony Ebusele in a world's person, see, in the inside this harbor research very well for time in memoria. He don't do inside very well, he did for people, but anyway, get to do harbor research in the inside. Doctor, good evening.
Thank you very much. God bless you.
All right, but for us, yes, make all of us sit down, make look the things small, small. Dr. Liu Asigidi, make our first come to you. Now, again, what you say, they surprise the general public there. We go to here, say, most times, some of the drugs, when they come from China and India, a lot of them have drugs. But why we say una, where they decide? Una go to treat them like say herbal drugs, no fit work.
Well, thank you, Akololo. Well, first of all, you know, when we talk about herbal drugs, there is also the other we call orthodox pharmaceutical products. And the fact is that we not clearly just say herbal drugs, not fit work. But there's a notion by some people who believe say anything when they call herbal drug, say it must work or it they work. But now the difference between these two drugs, when we talk about herbal and the orthodox drugs, is that we'll find that now for a herbal drug, for us to say it they effective, it must pass through what we call some trials. Make I use what people gonna understand. But what do we find in this environment? We say now somebody will tell you say this na herbal preparation, say the nine it they work. But this herbal drawing they use for people, oftentimes you discover say they don't analyze them, they don't know. If you ask them say what is inside the content, they don't know. If you ask them say, okay, this particular drug now when you say it is effective, how many people you don't use that for? When you say they don't get the positive result. Oftentimes, even the one where they will tell you, if you go back, you discover say truly that thing it not really work for the person. So we're not talk say in those days before these products we are talking about, we used to know of what they used to treat malaria like dogoyaro, those days. And you know it's at times most of the time you get results from dogoyaro when we were small, because that was the only thing that was available. But what we are saying is that herbal drug or herbal preparations, before they are acceptable, you must take them through the process. It gets bodies when they regulate medical practice, both orthodox and the non-orthodox. You must pass through the process. Let them certify, say, this thing where they call herbal drug, say, they efficacious, they effective. Because what we don't discover, we say some of these things, because they never synthesize them, they never really, you know, pass them through the process. Some things when they inside those herbs, some of them are toxic. That means they are poisonous to the body. But they need to be able to extract those things before they can become, before somebody can now declare them efficacious. That means you need to pass through that process. And in the course of passing through that, they will try the drugs to go through what we call clinical trial. Then, by the time they now say, okay, yes, it is true, this drug is working. You remember the days of HIV? You remember people like Agbada Kaden, who came out to say he has found a cure for this and that. And at the end of the day, they discovered that it was not right. It was not correct. So we, not we say, we just say anything where it comes from here, no good. But what I say, they should make more effort to ensure, say, that thing passed through the process we're supposed to pass through, so that we will know and be able to certify, say, this thing actually they work.
Thank you very much.
God bless you. You see, from his beginning,
before you respond, make I ask you a question.
Okay.
Madagascar, because when they look at homegrown solution to this COVID-19, supposing this virus now, you know, COVID finish, what will work on?
Let me start from where he started.
You get time to talk.
Mm-hmm.
Madagascar don't come out, bring one thing. I think for the last time I checked, now only one death they don't record. And that's one condition.
Just of recent. They were having no death before.
Now one death they don't record. And now they produce a thing. What do they do? When we say, you see what Dr. Tom just now. He say most of the drugs that they do, now they pass them through. What do they do?
We have a period to discuss. Let us not cover all that once.
Okay.
From where he started, it's a pity. Pity in the sense that the failure of everything is the handwork of our government. In China, everything that is happening in China, everything that's happening in China is the handwork of the government of China. What can the traditional medicine do here in Nigeria when the means are not there, the money is not there? Follow the due process. These are common people in the village. They are producing, they are researching, or their own effort. They have no cover. But in China, the government are responsible for all expenses, for all everything. If they see what you are doing, it's good. We are not saying we will not follow the due process, we will not do this or that. Where is the support? But what he mentioned that the traditional medicines are toxic, it's not true. It's never toxic. Traditional medicines are so safe that whatever, if at all it's a common immune booster, as good as leaves. If there is an excess, your body will waste it away naturally and throw it away. You see, he mentioned Abaraka. Abaraka is who? Abaraka is a medical doctor. It's not a traditional medicine doctor. I visited Abaraka when HIV was a problem in this country. Because we were tired. People were sick. What do we do? They say there is no cure from orthodox medicine. We have to find a way we begin to find a way on our own. What can we do? We lost a lot of people. When we started looking for a way, we discovered that this HIV had been in existence. People have died with it. People, they died with this very virus. But by the time they died with it, doing what they say, they begin to blame a wizard and which forces, because HIV is a disease that when you have it, does not give you a new disease, a new problem. You begin to have a stomach pain. You begin to have unfinished dysentery. The appetite is lost. You cannot eat food. But you will swallow all those flagellates and attacking you are swallowing before. That will not be responded. But what they will tell you will say that they have poisoned you. If you go to native doctors, they have poisoned you. If you go to a person in the church, the person will say that they have given you affliction, things like that. But when we found out that, it was not true. It was just HIV that is responsible for all this. At the end, God so kind with us, we're able to find a therapy. HIV disease, the best medicine to treat HIV is from traditional medicine. What we found us at that time survived so many people. Now, what is from the Western world? They say you will take it for life. You cannot, they don't know the meaning of that life. That life is either tomorrow or a month.
But when you say...
But excuse me, those that have done message today, which is called ARV, with wonderful antibiotics, they see I have some symptoms along with them. They see lost the appetite.
Yes, yes. But when you
their say, legs yes, are still like yes, yes, best
but,
legs.
But when you say the best way to treat HIV is...
I said the best therapy for the treatment of HIV is still from traditional medicine.
Okay,
But unknown to people now. I know this. I know what people have survived from the therapy we found at last.
But
I am the person that claimed that time. Abaraka is not a traditional doctor. He's a medical doctor. When I visited Abaraka, Abaraka said that his therapy, that when you have HIV virus, donate a pint of blood from you, that he uses the plasma to to transfer it back to your system. That is the choice he's using. But I didn't say, if that is possible, it would be better done by the Western world. But if you are HIV patients at that time, you don't have enough blood, you pay $25,000 at that time to a patient who have enough blood to donate a part of blood for you. A part of blood of HIV patient will cost you $25,000. It uses the plasma, reject it. I said, no, it will not be possible like that. God, these are problems. I have people that were suffering from this disease. I visited the other man, Winans, they were not there. God, they didn't have the therapy of herbal medicine he was using. But it was clear that there's a herbal medicine. So we return back home and find a therapy.
So your own winner is that even because when doctor talk, you see, don't say some of these herbal things, you know, they work. You see, just that some of them they are toxic.
Be the responsible with the federal government or the state government to assist the traditional, whichever way they want it. We have submitted my drugs to the Federal National Institute of Medical Research. They analyze all my drugs. Hardly before traditional medicine is never toxic. Acute and chronic toxicity were done here at the University of Benin. Before nitrate, Professor Adelusi done the chemical analysis. After that, bred Professor Ike Omagbale, acute and chronic toxicity. It was also, is 100% safe for human consumption? It was 500% safe for human consumption. What do okay. you want? At NIPRI, the certificate given to me was signed by three professors. What else do you want? That is what we use for HIV.
Okay.
As you were saying, coronavirus exists today.
Yes.
Well, it is a pity that here is a country. Kudos to Madagascar. In Madagascar, the president is seeking of herbal medicine, promoting herbal medicine in Madagascar. If such is done in Nigeria, supporting Nigeria traditional medicine will go to any length to find a cure for any disease in this country. A president of Madagascar claiming, promoting the traditional medicine, supporting traditional medicine. Let me tell you, look at what it is. Coronavirus is an important disease. That was also regulated here. From the China to the Europe, Europe's now more victims of the coronavirus. Look, I go to America, over 100,000 died. Go to Italy, the same thing with Spain and all. But here in Nigeria, we have victims of these diseases. Then what do we do? Madagascar does not go and start acting in Spain or China. What do they use to treat coronavirus? They went straight to the source of their power. Source of their power is traditional medicine. That is why they bring that. It's a war. How do you fight a war? You fight a war with all every means available with you to defend it, to save your people. Look at good things that happened in Madagascar. They did not lose anyone. What to do? Just of you say they lost one person. Is that too much?
Okay.
War, you go to the source of your medicine, source of your power.
Doctor, get with you. Mostly.
Thank you.
Doctor, get with you. At the
you know, just like you observe. I didn't really say that. Okay, let me speak PG. I not talk say traditional medicines are toxic. I didn't use that word blanket in the blanket manner. What I talk we say, I say the herbal medicines when would they use? You see, in everything, there is a good part of it, and there is a bad part of it. And if you separate the bad part, everything now becomes good. We never talk of the limitations where herbal practitioners get. We never go that side. Why be say they're not fit, you know, doing the way we're supposed to
be?
Would it be the limitations? You don't talk and say they need government and stuff. For example, if you want to even get your herbal drug approved by government, you need to go through a process. I went through it more than 10 different processes. You must have a registered company. You must have the name of the drug and the apart from the traditional name of the herb you are using, you should also know the botanical name of that herb. You should, if you don't have a company, you have to have a business name. You have to apply to NAFDAC. You have to do this up to more than 10 different steps you need to take. And just like he talk, it go hard for the village man to even go through that process.
Thank you.
I agree that they need support.
With your exposure, doctor, that's why we're here.
Yes.
With your exposure, because you are a man who we see he get vision.
Yes.
Don't you think, say, it don't reach time when we see the laws, when you look at what they happen around us, we can really prepare for you.
Yes.
No, I think prepare for you.
Ready?
Yes. Now, there's this sickness they call prostate.
Yes.
Somebody who I know very well, he go hospital. The head of department for Zamfara, he don't pay finish like this. He won't go theater. Now the head of department and say, look, you know the implication of what you are doing now. He said, no. He said, go home. He was advised to go. This person, I know a rich house, and this happened around the, which month be this now? Around January, February. Then at the end of the day, Nahaba, this thing, now they take, they solve the thing to tomorrow. That prostrate day, he got so many minutes of kind of chronic disease.
No, wait.
I recall. Because, like cancer, like there are some sicknesses, we're not going to encourage people say, go for this one, go for that one. Maybe you know, say the person go there. Don't you think it don't reach time? Say we're supposed to bring another regulation to actually upgrade our herbal institutions.
No, wait.
Yes.
There are regulations. Now that one they tell you just now. For example, now MDC, Medical and Dental Council of Nigeria.
Yeah.
It has a supervisory role over, you know, this herbal practice. NAFDAC, they have their own role in terms of guidelines for you to register, for them to certify, say this particular mess, if we take it, it not will kill us. But most of these things we are talking about don't go through that. Like prostate, where they talk so. If I see, I don't see many of these stories where they talk. What you just mentioned now. I even have close friends.
Mm-hmm.
But later on,
they
still come back. So the one you are talking about now, if I put him on phone and ask him a few questions, you go discover say he still gets symptoms of what we are talking about.
The ones who do the medical one, then they could die.
No. For you know the prostate where you bring. No, I have a senior uncle where they do prostatectomy for now. When I was in medical school, he's still alive. And he's the eldest person in my family right now as I speak. Medical school, you know how many years ago? So he's still there. And he's the oldest man in the village. So say the person die, not me say because the operator, now me can die. Because somebody where they know even operate. Somebody feel the worker just now die. So what are they talk? Be see, look, yes, we know say herbs day. But we have a lot of job that is yet undone.
That's what I'm telling you.
What they never do.
So
you can separate the active ingredient. In every drug, there's what we call active ingredient.
Okay.
You go separate that one. That one when you go be say, now you go make, now be the real thing when they work for inside. You go separate that. The Madagascar way they talk.
Yeah.
For example, the president just come for their meeting for South Africa. He say he get good news for them. They come see, nobody wouldn't go that side. Suddenly he say they get cure for
coronavirus.
And if you watch WHO, just wash the thing away like that. So, like the Madagascar issue, you know, before you claim, say you don't get cure for something, you must have documentary evidence. What do I mean? See, you will say, now this thing, I do one like this. This one, it work. Now so it be. I do this one like this, it work. You must have documentary evidence. Say, truly, this particular drug where you mention, say you don't use them and it work. But let me also tell you, if you watch this coronavirus when they talk, that is why, you know, just accept person claim like that, say, some people, they get coronavirus, but they don't get symptoms. And if they will continue like that, even whether you treat them or not, they go well. Are you getting me? They go, whether you give them drug or not, they go well. Because, like I used to tell people, viral diseases, most of the time are self-limiting. That means the body takes care of it. So it not me say, and the one where you say, now only one person die, I don't have that statistics. But it not me say, now the drug, you know what they did the drug when the man break on at the medicine, where would they take the treat malaria? No. Oh, yeah. It's not a new drug. So, but you must have documentary evidence.
Oh, so now the documentary evidence.
Hey, you must get evidence.
No,
before you go call and declare and say it's a cure.
Now then, why are they? So say now WHO, so say the thing, they work just now.
Before they do that one, before WHO will come and say this drug, they work, they don't take and through
scientific process.
Exactly.
Because the African country.
No. All over the world. All over the world. That's not because the African country.
Because the WHO said the thing no data ethic. We agree. But why we say that they treat her with kid gloves? It because it's not like UK or US or maybe all those Western world, they bring that one out. They're going to draw a yaga yaga like that.
No, that's why I say they push her off.
Okay, you agree say they push her off?
No, because yes. That's why the push out is for you to go, maybe go do your homework. Go do your homework. Show us evidence. Say, this is what you talk. Say, it really the work. If you bring the evidence, they will now go back again and analyze it. For example, the hydroxychloroquine and the hydroxychloroquine they are talking about, hydroxychloroquine they are talking about. You see, in some countries, they don't suspend them. The reason we say, one magazine. One and journal like that, Lancet.
Is suspended, a lot of people have died with it.
Now, Lancet probably say people when they take that drug, they are more likely to die. You know, yes, so? So they have to suspend because life is precious. So, okay, after suspending, they have to go back and reanalyze the data with themselves, say they get. Maybe they see whether what did they talk not true. Or it's not true. So that is that's how the thing they go. So nobody say, even if somebody come here and I tell us, say, look, I don't see one drug when they cure coronavirus or when they we don't hear so many things of cure of diabetes.
Yes, yes.
And the person will just go. I know person, one patient when we say if they admission like this, if the doctor say they say they don't get cure for diabetes, one can go ask. Now I tell her, say, I know so many no go there, but still do what the doctor said. They tell them, say, me, they don't take that one. By the next weekend, by say, my mother died. And the drug, when you go buy one bottle, 30,000 naira. Said, my mother died. Whereas, it's for you to control blood sugar and take care of the wound where the woman get. So, we're not just saying, but no, prove no, it.
But
that
you,
this
you, get, you get one area where you talk. Because for this matter, the Oga did a little bit down. He said that the thing concerned them well. Now you talk about most of these herbal drugs that they come from the villages. What are they trying to let you know? So, let you see, at your level now, think you be a member of NMA, Abi. Don't you see NMA as an association? Now don't reach one I'm supposed to begin to canvass for this country. Is it true that other countries like China China and India, they use herbal drugs? Is it true?
You see, I will not say it is not true. Okay. But again, if you watch most of those multivitamins that come from these nations, even NAFDAC themselves, they still look at them. And most of them are actually multivitamins. So we don't regard them as complementary, but rather alternative. You know what I mean? So you use this one, the orthodox, and use this one along, it will work. No. If you choose to go use that one, it's left for you. So what I'm saying is, yes, we can say, okay, since we have these herbs around us, let's begin to look at them. But let's begin to look at the content.
Let's begin to look at the content. Let's begin to look at them. But wait, what I'm telling you, you people, as NMA, we don't really do anything like that. Wait. NMA, they consider anything about Haba or something. Now, we don't make a bad. That's true, now.
Wait.
Yes.
As you know, if you read the Bible,
yes,
David was going to war, and Saul called David and said, David, I have an armor, carry this one away and go and face Goliath. But David said, after he wore it, he said, look, king, I never tried this kind of one before, so this one will give me so too heavy for me. In medical training, we're not trained to use herbs.
Thank you.
So we're not trained to use herbs. It is what you know that works that we use, what you are used to. You get what I'm saying?
Yes, sir.
If I know that, for example, a patient comes to me, he has appendicitis, and I know the solution is to go there and remove the appendix and tie up the place and close back, and the patient is well. Then you now come to tell me that there's a herb I can give for appendicitis that will cure it. For me, I leave that choice to the patient. But I will tell the patient the implication.
Still speak pigeon, not even.
Sorry. I will leave that one for the patient. But I will still tell the patient, say, the risk when they take so. Because if they give you that thing, it don't work. Because you are not using yourself as a guinea pig. If they give you, it don't work, and the appendix busts inside you, and you die, you have nobody to blame. So it is what we are used to. It's like you are working in this television house. You know that if you come here and we talk like this, they will air it. Then somebody now bring one thing and tell you that, look, there is one thing like this, I'll give it to you. When you talk like this, they will hear you from America. You will just carry on. No. Until they have proven it.
We never finish your doctor.
Yes.
See, the area when I want to move down, we say, all of us grow for this country.
Yes.
We grow Miss Dogoyaro as a foundation. We grow go meet some kind thing we call Ude. When our grandmother used that time, most of the days they work. You know, being say it don't reach when we say governments, but actually strengthen research institutions about this our harbor this thing based on this.
To my knowledge, I think there is a center that does that in terms of all this herbal research.
But the limitation come.
Wait, you see, there are limitations, I agree, because even health sector, government, we allocate 5% of the budget to the entire healthcare system of the country. And at the end of the day, they will not even release all the monies. So limitations is not just to herbal practitioners, it's also affecting other medical practitioners. So what they, you know, on their own, if you have, like he has said just now that he has researched into a particular herbal drug, and I forgot what he says, the thing treats.
HIV.
But if he says that, he should also provide documentary evidence. Mm-hmm. Let us know how many patients he has given it to. Mm. First of all, we'll do the HIV test before start the drug. We'll do the test again. Mm-hmm. If we do it again and it's negative, kudos to him. Mm-hmm. Then we start referring all the HIV patients to him. So, but if we do one,
Doctor, I think the discussion is becoming too long. It's too long for one person. It's too long now. If I go back to where you started, how many minutes do you have for this discussion? This is too much.
So that is just it. If what we need is cure for ailment. If a bad practitioner can give us a cure for COVID-19, we'll be so happy. All of us will key into it and we'll start patronizing, you know, whoever finds the cure. So that's just the thing.
Thank you. God bless you. You see, it's so long down that to start from where you started.
You
this
just started. You don't get the flow. You tell.
Okay. Well, let me start from the failures. Failures of our government to take this thing up with traditional medicine. If I say failure of the local government, failure of the state government, failure of the federal government, everything lies on the federal government. What are we talking about? As we are talking about coronavirus now, a war. You are talking about WHO. What is meant world WHO? Are we fools? Doesn't mean we don't have our weapon to fight any war that we see? People will die. Okay. Where do you think that people are dying? What is it? Just people are just going. But the best of all this is the traditional medicine practitioner to be well embraced by the government of the day.
But what do you think the government could do? He mentioned that there is somebody
who treated a portrait till now is alive. That the one who went to another place, that person is gone. In traditional medicine practices, there is no regulation. You don't know what Mr. A is doing.
No regulation.
You don't know what Mr. A is doing. You don't know what Mr. B is doing. You don't know what Mr. C is doing. Everybody will just come out, claim. You see, a conscious human being, with spiritual traditional medicine, claiming. What is not supposed to be like that? I contributed to the traditional medicine bay in 2006. The same time with NACA bay. The government passed the NACA bay and leave the traditional medicine bill aside. If that bill is passed, that will be regulation of the price of traditional medicine in Nigeria.
Because
if you are a real doctor, you will be known as a real doctor.
Yeah.
If you are a spiritual doctor, oracle doctor, you will be known as oracle doctor. He's a family physician now. The area is cleared. Any person that area will go to him. Traditional medicine practitioners in Nigeria is not like that. Everybody, based on his discussion of what he or she knows, it's not supposed to be like that. That's why people are confused. They will tell a patient, well, go to traditional medicine. By the time you go there, you mean that the patient is beginning to play oracle for you. Begin to bring your brother and your mother for village. How they take with you. That is not how it's supposed to be. The best is, if the bill is passed, there will be regulation. No area where somebody belong.
That is to say, for traditional medicine, herbal practice to actually get the
areas of specialization. Like myself with you here now, I'm not a general practitioner. I only deal on viruses. HIV took me to a length of so many viruses infection. If you come to the human papilloma virus now, I know where it started, from Medopotassium syndrome. But I laugh over it. At that time of Medopotassium, if you are able to use a particular traditional method, it will save you for the future cancer. If at the beginning of that human papilloma virus is just developed or use disease, you know the herbs to use, you escape, the cancer is becomes at last. But people live here for America to go and spend more cancer, that is all are research sector. But in Nigeria, there is nothing like that. And the worst of all, let me use that, sorry to say that. He is a consultant now. But knowledge of traditional medicine is not there with him. He ought not to have been like that. That is what supposed to be. If all traditional medicine, all orthodox in Nigeria,
okay,
orthodox
before that, because all international best practices.
They are supposed to have knowledge about traditional medicine. But if at all they are not using it, they don't have that. In the university, add it to that. In Ghana, it's like that. In China, it's like that.
Okay.
In Vietnam, it's like that. Have you said, if you ask what is happening there, in Vietnam, you see that somebody will last about 100 years, still very, they depend on their herbal medicine to live. That is why the orthodox medical practitioner, they don't have the knowledge. They look at traditional medicine as a crude something. They look at it that it's not safe for human consumption. Whether traditional medicine is this never. Let me tell you, when there was no all this equipment, those days when we depend on our parents, do you know what our parents use as a pH meter? Their tongue. When you finish your traditional medicine, you put it at your tongue. Your tongue will tell you the position of that. If it is too salty, if it is so acidic, if it's so alkaline, your tongue will tell you. Talk less now. And the traditional medicine that is prepared now, a pH meter will tell you the level of the acid and the level of alkaline. If the acid is too high, you bring add more alkaline to come back to reduce the acid. If the alkaline is too high, you increase the acid. When our pH 6 to 7, that drug, traditional medicine, is safe for human consumption. There are so many things good from the Western world now. Even some preparations, some filtering materials, when I do even some cups to drink traditional. Those days, you drink traditional medicine with coconut cup. You drink traditional medicine with snake cup. They were not there. But traditional Western will still contribute for the process and the success of provision of traditional. No, you cannot have a good bottle to bottle your traditional medicine very well. But those days, it was not like that. If plastic rubbers are not prepared, can the traditional medicine prepare a plastic container? No, it's not possible. But what I am saying, they ought to have had knowledge of traditional medicine. Our practitioners go. The sick goes to the hospital. The sick does not go to the traditional doctor unless the problem is now becoming not responding to what they are giving that patient from the hospital. Look at so many other things. There are so many diseases that ought to have been treated with traditional medicine that claim life of so many people. Look at, we were talking about coronavirus. What of Lassa fever? Lassa fever claim lives more than coronavirus in our country here. Lassa fever. The chances of surviving today from that drug they are using, what they say from China, does not up to 30% for surviving. You cast a patient, that person, the work is in Lassa fever. As we are talking about coronaviruses now, coronavirus and Lassa virus and all these are diseases that when you contacted it, you will be isolated. Traditional medicine will not have access to that patient. What they are treating there, either good or bad, the patient remain there, either lucky to survive or die, which is not good. If the traditional medicine practitioners are there, if a Lassa patient is there, if what we apply is used to also traditional medicine to apply for this patient, you see that so many people will be surviving these diseases. If we didn't go and source medicine for when HIV was killing, we don't have the opportunity of having so many people that survive it. HIV is a transmitted sexual disease. It's developed for years to develop. Coronavirus is not like that. Lassa virus is not like that. Ebola virus is not like that. Coronavirus now attack you immediately. You begin to notice a sensation at the nose, from there to the throat. From there, it stops at the lungs. It's there. If it goes to stomach, it will die. Use the hot water, it will kill it. Use this one. But I am telling you right from here that coronavirus does not mean it will be too mean. If you know what viral drugs is for traditional medicine. Bring people forward. 10 mil for an antiviral, which I know. If you take 10 mil, it's like smoke before you drink it, so smoke will come out from your this thing. So it goes into the, no matter what the virus, that 10 mil alone will paralyze the Ebola, the coronavirus. What paralysis mean that? It's weakening the virus. What next? It's your immune system to overcome this thing. If traditional medicine is not there, it's not well put in place, my brothers, I'm telling you, innocent ignorance will not be going away like that. God helps you, devil, both state and invite people, ask them what they are. If today now in Edo State, there's no traditional medicine board.
Okay.
That would have been a place the governor would visit at first. Every government have access.
We don't argue, Rich. We didn't come here to prove a point.
Yes.
We come here for a way forward. If at all, at the end of the day, because we don't say politics, therefore WHO. And therefore, what would they see? It's difficult to say WHO will certify that Madagascar. We will see the world drug. Now, if truly that Madagascar drug, to that extent, to say which way will it be so, you know, if you say Dana welcome development, then that is there for our country, Nigeria. You don't talk of the different constraints. You not just say you get the way we say government for facility check or drop some of these stringent ways. When we say all this, they say they check, not say we don't see they don't check all these Harvard drugs so that at least themselves could grow up rather than this.
Rather than say stringent, first of all, if Madagascar they claim it they work.
Yeah, for Corona.
If it truly they work, of course, it's a welcome development. Everybody go embrace and begin to use the drug so that nobody go die. Then this issue of say whether they should relax the stringent regulations.
Not necessarily relax.
Wait, I'm trying
what
to.
What can government do in
okay,
this
now,
term? Because
now,
because like I said, the research they at the lowest end.
Now, at present, there are about 3-4 traditional drugs, or let me use the word herbs, that NAFDAC is already investigating.
For coronavirus?
Yes. There are about 3-4. Because people have applied. They have sent in their application. If you sabi read and write, you know, despite say all those things long, you discover, say, you can easily, first of all, apply. So NAFDAC, they have received about 3-4 applications like that. And they are already looking into them. Because, you know, if life is precious, that's why there has to be stringent regulations. So that, you know, we just claim, say, this thing, they work. And at the end of the day, you collect money from people and they die of what you give them. So I think government on their own, yes, they have to regulate. But again, they also give some, especially in an emergency situation like this, for them to have received 4 applications and they already attended to them, that means they are giving some concession in terms of this emergency situation. So, but there's no way government will allow everybody to be proclaiming that I can do this. In fact, in my own view, you know, medical doctors don't advertise.
Yes.
Traditional medicine practitioners should not go on TV and be advertising. The reason is this. The Bible also tells us that your gift makes room for you. Your gift makes room for you. If there's something you know how to do, and you do it very well, people, wherever they are, they will look at you. But when you start going on television, you say you can cure HIV, you can cure corona, you can cure everything in this world, you are misleading the people. So in my view, they should not be allowed to advertise on television.
Yes.
So, but let the work they do, advertise them.
That's a preliminary. I'm not really answer my question. What team are you to see for this country? Eh?
Yes.
You know, should say governments want make the herbal research work stand. They now go to NAFDAC, go to this, go to like we talk. An old man in the village who knows a particular herb for one particular thing. Before you go through that, maybe you go down all your lifetime, you go down that.
See.
So, no, what cannot be done? Because when I've done the research institute and all of that, you come and I say, they more important. What is it? Okay, now if we ask you as a doctor now, for the past 20 years, which I have a drug, now we don't follow proof on this country, we say, okay, they can't recommend for hospitals. You did?
Well, in our hospitals, we don't recommend herbal because it's not a herbal hospital. It's not a herbal hospital. It's not a herbal hospital. So we cannot recommend.
No, I'll say, is there any drug? Now, what would they talk now? We say, if the thing passed through that and this and that, and at the end of the day, it can't come out, they feel recommended.
Yes.
Now, what I'm trying to say, we will look for the past 20 years. You don't ever see any drug
from any
country when we say, no, NAFDA, don't listen, I have a drug. So, okay, they can say, okay, maybe they use it for hospital.
No, see, like...
For instance...
You say from any country?
For Nigeria, yeah.
Okay, from Nigeria. No, I'm not seeing.
Okay, now, if by the time, for instance, WHO can't clear this COVID, this Madagascar, for instance, if they clear up and it's not working, and WHO say me they use them, will they not be using the hospital?
Wait. You know your questions are coming. Now let me tell you. Despite I say that, look, there are herbal drugs that NAFDAC have given a NAFDAC number made in this country. Are you getting me? They are in existence. I have seen them. But for me, as a medical practitioner, like I told you before, I said I will only recommend what I know. I didn't study herbal medicine in the university. I studied medicine, orthodox medicine.
Okay, are you
so
saying,
it is what I know.
So are you saying that in other countries, such drugs that go because I'm a novice, just like I'm a novice in that area. You know, say for other countries, like India and China
Vietnam,
and other countries, drugs will come through herbal this research, and then only they are certified to be okay.
You have qualified it yourself. You don't answer the question. You said they are certified to be okay. What is
do they use them in the hospital?
I never go there before. I don't
let me tell you, doctor. You yes. See, the doctors, the traditional doctors say that they are baptizing. That is what I'm talking about.
Those are normal drugs.
You say Yoruba there, a Yoruba woman carrying drugs for head. We load them with 20 bottles. Around 12, 1 o'clock, he's coming back with empty bottles. Every day like that. Those are not what I'm advertising.
No.
I cannot have that. I handle rare cases. That is what I work on. Rare cases that cannot be except all those are common. Those are common. Like flagellate.
Go back to my question.
You
say you go abroad that time. Now, sure. You go abroad that time.
Yeah.
My question be see, I never go abroad before. I never go that corner. I don't be doctor.
I represent my country.
I talk about this field of human treatment. The question is, now I ask and say, for other country, two questions I ask and say, if tomorrow, WHO talk say this Madagascar drug is good, doctors not go recommend that.
Cool.
The second thing, I say in the last 20 years or 30 years, herbal research, medical herbal research board through this country, which drug they don't come out from herbal, where we say they call the use for our hospital, you know they.
Now black
hold on. Now, because okay, if not, so for other country, drug will go through this process, they're not the user for their own hospital. You don't understand? So, the question is that.
If you talk of now black in Nigeria, NAFDAC give you a safety certificate for herbal medicine. What it does not state it there. If you squeeze bitter leaf liquid, you cook dogoyaro. You cannot go meet there. You say they give you number. Advanced traditional medicine, not need number. You see, if you have the safety certificate, apply. That is what you see in the public. That's what NAFDAC is doing.
You talk about government just now.
Yes.
You have to follow my own line of argument. My own line of argument is, if you get this thing tomorrow this thing now, NAFDAC can't go through them. Nigeria is used to have a say don't do them. Even don't do them. This is going to work. How come that they're not using for hospital?
But to avoid too much expenses, if the producer of that drug say this drug is used for coronavirus,
for instance,
all what you need, look at the safety. If NAFDAC, if say National Institute of Medical Research in Abuja, do all the analysis that this drug is safe, claimed by that traditional doctor, go and use it. In the next 48 hours, it will give you results.
So
that will happen.
Who is in the position to recommend it, that medicine, no hospital, they use
it. But the NAFDAC can only go for the safety. It's the claimant who produces a drug for a particular disease. We say this is what this drug is doing.
Doctor,
then
doctor,
use it.
Doctor,
if you want to follow the evaluation or this and that, in the next 15 years,
who will be the person where go fit, say, use this drug for hospital?
Let me tell you,
okay.
Medicine is not like that.
Okay.
Uh-huh. No, but no, see. Drugs are produced, there are different drugs that are produced. It's the doctor himself, the man in charge of managing that case, that decides whatever drug he wants to use. You get what I'm saying? So it's not, even if somebody produces drug, Even if federal government say go and use that drug, I as a consultant, I can choose not to use it. It can't force me.
Mm-hmm. Because you are paying for orthodox.
Yes, because it is what like I keep saying. They're not. It's now what did I know? Now we use. Nobody will tell me. Say you must use
that. That is the problem.
That is responsibility.
That is
all. If the patient die.
Okay.
So am I not going to say it's because somebody say I should use it?
Time not again.
Well, I talked to a professor.
Yes. No, time
a professor said that a traditional doctor. He is a professor. Yeah. I take you to the professor. Hospital is a place when you come, whether survive or die.
Yeah.
They have their hair. So what do I use some orthodox, either good or bad, we begin to use it. It's the person that knows.
Okay.
That is the truth.
Sir Abu Sele.
Thank you.
Time not again.
Okay.
Say greet our people.
Thank you very much, my people of Edo State and Nigeria. I'm happy to say something out today to hear from me.
Okay.
God will bless you, and God Almighty will bring solution to coronavirus in Jesus' name.
Amen. Dr. Sigiri, what is the name you for?
Yes.
You will come in.
So tell us
how you talk in, as a consultant.
Well, Asikiri Leona, that be my name. I be a consultant family physician, and I work for UBTH. For me, they trained me for about 6-7 years as a doctor. And I swore to an oath that is what I would do all my life.
Uh-huh.
Anything outside that, when I don't know, I'm not going to do it.
Uh-huh.
So help me God.
Thank you.
All right, that's all we'll wrap up the program this
Thank
week.
You.
Everything we'll say on the here, that's all we'll do. God bless our country. And the solution to COVID-19, it will come one way or the other. God bless Nigeria. Until next week, Monday, we'll be with Nigeria on this program. All right, I say bye-bye and God bless Nigeria. Thank you.